Good morning, one and all. So here I am going to present one of the best topic: thin cylinders and spherical cells. What is cylinders and spherical cells? Actually, they are carriers, fluid carriers, generally used for storage of high pressure fluids, liquids like chemicals, gases, all those fluids. Even sometimes just grains also. So cylinders are generally two types. One is thin, another is thick. And what is the mechanism to divide cylinder into two categories? One is thin and other one is thick. The mechanism is simply taking the two parameters of the cylinder. One is your thickness, another one is the internal diameter. And the relation is that if internal diameter of the cell is more than equal to 20 times of thickness of the cell, then it is called as thin cylinder. Otherwise, if it is less than that, then it is called thick cylinder. For that, I am going to share my slide. Let us see. This is a clear picture. This is a huge vessel. This is also called as cylinder, which is the storage of chemicals like petroleum product, gasoline products, diesel, petrol, like this. This is also a spherical vessel. This is also a thin cylinder, either or thick cylinder. So these are the devices which are used for the storage of huge fluids under high pressure. But in case of thin cylinder, the pressure carrying capacity is must be between 10 atmosphere to 30 atmosphere. 1 atmosphere is equal to approximately 100 kilopascal. It is actually 1.325 kilopascal, but atmosphere will take 100 kilopascal. So it is the fluid capacity, the fluid pressure of the fluid in the cylinder is 10 to 30 atmospheres. Now, next see. This is the introduction that already stored. Displayed in the tanks, boilers, compressed air receivers like this. Now, see, failure of cylinder due to internal pressure. Since it receives high pressure fluids, so pressure causes burst. There are two types when the thin cylinder is subject to internal fluid pressure. It may fail in two ways. One is called circumferential failure. Circumferential failure means a cylinder fails into two of equal upper halves, like in two troughs. Trough. That is, two trough means along the length, longitudinal. So circumferential failure is the split of two troughs into two halves along the length. Whereas second type of failure is longitudinal failure, means the cylinder splits into two equal parts, other part, two unequal parts, but along the circumference. Means two cylinders splits into two cylinders. There are two ways. Next, see, what are the stresses induced during the bursting or before bursting, where it carries a high fluid pressure, high fluid order pressure, or fluid under high pressure. Now, before going to derive the equations of the stresses induced on it, let us assume what are the ideal things which is generally considered while calculating all those stresses. First one, the material of the cylinder is homogeneous and isotropic. Homogeneous means uniformly material is uniformly distributed across the sections, and isotropic means it shows equal property of